Hello. Today we will discuss concern to dimensional analysis. In the previous video, we were discussing about dimensional variable, dimensional constant, dimensional less constant, and dimensional less variables. Four types already we have seen. Students, in this class, let us take the one more concept, dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis. The dimensional analysis has three uses. I mean, in this class, we are going to study the uses of dimensional analysis. Students, dimensional analysis used in three purposes. First use is, dimensional analysis can be used to convert one system of units into another system of units. Into another system. Already we have a system of units, right? And second use is, dimensional analysis is used to check the correctness of a physical relation. If any physical relation is there, you can check whether the equation is correct or not. And third one is, dimensional analysis is used to obtain a relation between various physical quantities. One by one we will see. See here, uses of dimensional analysis. Uses of dimensional analysis. Uses of dimensional analysis. Right? First use is, it is used to convert one system of units into another system of units. What is the first use? Dimensional analysis is used to convert one system of units into another system of units. Right? This is the first case. I mean, we can convert SI into CDS, CDS into SI. Right or not? Second use is, dimensional analysis used. Dimensional analysis is used. Dimensional analysis is used. Is used. To check the correctness of equation. To check the correctness of physical relation. Correctness of physical relation. Physical relation. Second is. Right. Third use is, dimensional analysis is used to obtain relation between various physical quantities. Relation between various physical quantities. Three applications are there, three uses are there. One by one uses will explain in detail, that we will see.
Right, students.
The first use we will see conversion of one system of units into another system of units. The first use of dimensional analysis. Before that, students, we know the physical quantity. Physical quantity. Any quantity can be measured. That quantity we are calling physical quantity here. Right or wrong? Any physical quantity can be represented by this formula. Any physical quantity that can be represented by x equal to n into u. X equal to n into u. Here, what is x? X indicates physical quantity. N indicates numerical value of a physical quantity. Numerical value of a physical quantity. And u represents unit of a physical quantity. For example, shall I take mass equal to how much? 5 kg. Mass equal to 5 kg. Here, what is mass? Mass is a physical quantity. What is 5? 5 is a numerical value of a physical quantity. Then what is u represent? Kg. That is just a unit of a mass. Right or wrong? Similarly, l equal to how much? Length equal to 10 meter. X replaced by length. N replaced by 10 numerical value. And u represent by SI. Right or wrong? Any physical quantity can be represented by x is equal to n into u. Remember this line. Now, let us take a system. In the system, any physical quantity has the mass, length and time. Mass, length and time. And n1 is the numerical value of a physical quantity in a system. In one system, any one system you can take. Let us take in one system, a physical quantity. A physical quantity can be represented by x equal to how much? X equal to n1 into u. U represent what? Mass, length, time. Right? I mean, in a system, let us take a physical quantity. The physical quantity has the numerical value n1 and units in terms of mass, length, time. Mass, length and time. And what are the dimensions here? Let us take this value is m1, l1, t1. Right? Dimension of mass, I will take a value. Dimension of length, I will take b value. Dimension of time, I will take c value. I mean, in one system of units, a physical quantity can be represented by n1 into bracket m1, l1, t1. So, what is x? Physical quantity. Right or wrong? What is n1? Numerical value. M1, L1, T1. These are represent units in terms of mass, length and time. Right? And ABC. What the ABC indicates? ABC indicates dimension of mass, dimension of length, dimension of time. Right? Shall I call this equation one? Now let us take one more system. In one more system, let us take the physical quantity has the numerical value m2 and units represented by m2, l2, t2. Right? In another system, physical quantity can be written x equal to n2 into bracket how much? m2, l2, t2. Right? And what are the dimensions here again? A, B, C. In one system of unit, a physical quantity represented by this value. In another system of unit, physical quantity x equal to n2 into bracket m2, l2, t2 with the dimension a, b, c. Right? Now I will take equation number 2. Very simple. X represent physical quantity, here also x represent physical quantity. Just compare equation 1 and 2. What will you get? Right? If you compare equation 1 and 2, what will you get, students, here? Shall I take
x equal to x, this value, how much? N1 into bracket, M1, L1, T1, A, B, C. Recover. Equal to this value, how much? N2 into bracket, M2, L2, T2, A, B, C. Recover. Then from this one to right. From this n2 equal to how much? N2 equal to n1 into bracket m1 divided by l1 rest how much? That is it, right? Sorry, m1 divided by l1. Shall I take one more step here? Look at me. Into bracket shall I take m1 divided by m2 rest to a and l1 divided by l2 rest to b and then t1 divided by t2 rest to how much? That is c, right? This is what, how to convert one system of units into another system of units. This is general formula. The general formula, how to convert one system of units into another system of units. Students, I will take an example. Example, how to convert one system of units into another system of units. I mean, who can convert from SI system into CGS system, CGS system into SI system. Right? I will take an example. By taking the example only, you can explain. Remember this formula. What formula it is? N2 equal to N1 into bracket M1 by N2 raised to A, L1 by N2 raised to B, T1 by T2 raised to C. And now let us take it. Shall we go? See here. How to take the example? How to convert one system of units into another system of units? That will explain in detail. Shall I take now? Now I will take convert 10 newton into joule, 10 newton into time, 10 newton into time. This is example number one, right? Newton, what is Newton? SI unit of force. Newton is a SI unit of force. What is dyne? Dyne indicates CGS unit of force. Later on, shall I take? SI unit of force here. SI unit of force. Of force is nothing but Newton. Is Newton. Right? CGS unit of force. CGS unit of force. CGS unit of force is time. Nothing but time. I can convert SI system into CGS system. SI system into CGS system. Shall we go, students? Now here we have the formula. How to convert one system into another system? I mean SI into CGS. For that we have the direct formula. Actually, you know the force formula. Force. What is force? Force equal to mass into acceleration. That we are calling M into A. M into A. Right around here. Then how about the dimensional formula? Dimensional formula equal to much? M L T raised to minus 2. M L T raised to minus 2. See here, anything is there equal to 1, this is 1. And students, here they are represented by A, B, C. Right now, see here, A replaced by how much? 1 value. B replaced by how much? Again 1 value. ML T raised to minus 2. and C represent how much? That is minus 2.
For this point. Now, we know that how to convert one system of units into another system of units. That formula already we know.
What are the values? N2 equal to N1 into bracket how much? M1 divided by M2 raised to K. Right. L1 divided by L2 raised to B. T1 divided by T2 raised to C. Right, how this is? Right.
This formula.
Here N1 is nothing but SI unit. SI value of force. Already N1 is given. How much N1? N1 equal to 10. Right. To understand this again, now I will take two columns. One is the SI system, second one is the CGS system. I will take like this. SI system. Right. CGS system I will take. CGS system. Right. Two columns are given. In both columns, mass, length, time is common. Shall I take M1, L1 and B, right, along with what value? N1 value, N1, right. Here also, shall I take M2, L2, how much? T2 and M2 value, right. In SI system, M1 equal to, I will take 1 kg.
I will take 1 kg
and L1 equal to I will take 1 meter.
What I will take? 1 meter.
T1 I will take 1 second.
What I will take? 1 second.
And L1 already given. L1 is equal to how much? 10 meter. This is equal to how much? That is solid 10. L1 equal to 10. But in CGS system, what I will take? M2 equal to 1 gram. Here SI unit is kg, SI CGS unit is nothing but what? Gram. M2 value is this. Right? L2 length here 1 meter. Shall I take here? 1 centimeter I will take. In CGS unit, time is measured in second. SI unit also time is measured in second. That's what I will take. I will take 1 second. L2 I need to calculate. I need to calculate L2, right?
Got is like this. What you got? You made two columns. One is the SI, second one is CGS. Yes, I written M1, L1, T1. I written M2, L2, T2. Here N1 value 10, M2 value I need to calculate.
We have the direct formula here. N2 equal to N1 into bracket M1 by N2, L1 by L2, T1 by T2. Here raised to A, raised to B, raised to C.
Students here. I need to some modify here.
1 kg mean how much gram? 1 kg mean 1000 gram. Shall I take? 1 kg equal to 1000. 1000 can be written 10 raised to 3.
10 raised to 3. 1 into 10 raised to 3 equal to 1000.
1 meter. 1 meter mean how much centimeter? 1 meter mean 100 centimeter. 100 can be written. Shall I take? 100 can be written like this. 10 dash to 2 centimeter, right? 10 dash to 2 centimeter, like this here. Shall we go? Directly. Look at this formula. N2 equal to L1 into bracket M1 by L2, L1 by L2, T1 by T2. Now, how to put this values? N2 equal to, N2 equal to, N1, what is the N1? 10 value, keep up saying, into bracket. M1 equal to 1 kg or how much gram? 10 raised to 3 gram. 10 raised to 3 gram. Whole divided by. M2 equal to how much? 1 gram. Equal to 1 gram. Raised to A. A. Raised to A. A equal to how much? 1 value. Right? Again, L1 by L2. What is L1? L1 equal to 1 meter. 1 meter means how many centimeters? 10 raised to 2 centimeters. 10 raised to 2 centimeters. Whole divided by L2. L2 equal to 1 centimeter. 1 centimeter. Raised to B. B value how much? That is 1. T1 by T2. T1 mean 1. T2 mean 1. Raised to C. C mean minus 2. Are you following this? Right or wrong? See your students. Gram, gram get cancelled, centimeter, centimeter get cancelled. Here second get cancelled. 1 second, 1 second. 1 second and 1 second. They get cancelled again. Then what is remaining? See here. N2 equal to 10. Into bracket. See here. 10 dash to 3 by 1. 10 dash to 3. Right? Right or wrong? Into 10 raised to 2 divided by 1. That is 10 raised to 2. Right or wrong? This side. 1 by 1 raised to minus 2. That is how much? That is 1 only. Right? Again, shall I take? 10 cube tak said 10 raised to 3 into 10 raised to 2. How much? 10 raised to 5. 10 raised to 5 into 10. How much this is? 10 raised to 6. 10 raised to 6. I mean, from this what you got? M2 is nothing but CGS system. N1 is nothing but how much? SI system. From this we got 10 Newton equal to 10 Newton equal to 10 raised to 6 dyne. 10 Newton equal to 10 raised to 6 dyne. N1 is nothing but how much? 10. N2 is nothing but 10 raised to 6. Then 10 Newton equal to 10 raised to 6 times. 10 raised to 6 times. You can take one more example. See this numerical for a few seconds. We will start one more numerical. Right, shall you go? Shall I go for one more example? How to convert one system of units into another system of units? Look at me. See here. Second example I will take. Convert. 1000 newton into time. You can see 1000 newton on a time walakan on Marath. SI unit of force. What is SI unit? That is nothing but Newton. What is CGS unit? What are calling dyne? First, we will write dimensional formula for the force. What is the dimensional formula for the force? Force equal to how much? ML T raised to minus 2, 1, 1 value. Right? Here, M raised to A, L raised to B. E raised to C4. A equal to 1. B equal to 1. C equal to minus 2. Right? As you see in the previous class, numerical. Now, two columns I will make again. One is the SI system, second one is the CGS system. SI system. And CGS system. CDS system. Right? Now, in this one, what are the mass? M1 is the mass, L1 is the length, T1 is the time. N1 is given. What is the N1? N1 is equal to 1000. N1 equal to 1000. Right? Similar here, mass is nothing but m2, length is nothing but l2, time is nothing but t. N2 I need to calculate. Right. In SI system, I will take mass as 1 kg. Mass as 1 kg. Here I will take mass as 1 gram. Right. L1, length I will take 1 meter. Your length I will take 1 centimeter. Right. Your time I will take. Time I will take 1 second. Here also time what I will take? 1 second. Because SI unit of time, that is nothing but second. CGS unit also second. N1 here 1000, N2 I need to calculate. Better off. Right. Now we have the general formula. General formula is there. What is the general formula? N2 equal to N1. M1 divided by M2. Rest how much? K. Right. Into. L1 divided by L2. Rest to B. Into. T1 divided by T2 rest to how much? C. Like this. See here. 1 kg mean how much gram? 1 kg mean 10 raised to 3 gram. 1000 gram. 1 kg mean 1000 gram. 1 kg under 1000 gram. 1 meter or centimeter is 10 raised to 2 centimeter, 1000 centimeter. 1000 centimeter. Remember this point. Shall we direct here? What you got? N2. N1. What is N1? 1000. 1000. Right. M1. M1 under 1 kg is the S gram of the 10 raised to 3 gram of the. What did you? 10 to 3 gram, whole divided by M2 and rest to 1 gram. Rest to A, A and rest to the 1 gram. A equal to 1. L1, L1 mean 1 meter or 10 to 2 centimeter. Divided by L2 mean 1 centimeter. Rest to B, B is how much? That also 1. Into. T1 equal to 1, T2 equal to 1. C, minus 2, right? This is second, this also second, this also second, right? Gram, gram cancel, centimeter, centimeter cancel, second, second cancel, right? Now, N2 equal to 10, 1000, 1000 mean how to write? 10 raised to 3, right? Into. 10 raised to 3 by 1, that is 10 raised to 3. 10 raised to 2 by 1, how much? 10 raised to 2. 1 by 1 raised to minus 2, that is 1. Right? 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to 2, 10 raised to 5. 10 raised to 5 into 10 raised to 3. 10 raised to 8. 10 raised to 8. From this what you got? You got that? 1000 Newton. 1000 Newton equal to 10 raised to 8 die. 10 raised to 8 die. Right? This is how to convert one system of unit into another system of unit. We'll take one more example, students. We'll take one more example how to convert one system of unit into another system of unit. That we'll see series numerical for few seconds. I will take one more example now. Convert. 10 joule, 10 joule into urge, convert 10 joule into urge.
Joule is a SI unit of work. Joule is a SI unit of work. Urge is a CGS unit of work. Agree? Now we know the work dimensional formula. So write this work. What is the work dimensional formula? M L square T raised to minus 2. Right or wrong? This is the dimensional formula of the work. Already we have written in a column. We made physical quantity, we made physical formula, dimensional formula in the unit. Right or wrong? Here. Anything is equal to 1. A equal to how much? A equal to 1. B equal to 2. C equal to minus 2. Right or wrong? Right. I. Again we make the two columns. One column is what? SI 16. One column is nothing but SI 16. Second column is how much? CGS 16. CGS 16. Right? Right off. Look at me. Here I will take M1. Mass, here I will take L1, what I will take time T1, M1 I will take, right. I will take mass M2, length L2, time T2, here by it, right. Mass, in SI-16, mass nothing but 1 kg I will take, here how much I will take, 1 centimeter. In SI-16, mass length I will take 1 meter. 1 meter. Here how much I will take? 1 centimeter. Right or time here 1 second. Here also how much? 1 second. N1 is given 10 joule. 10 joule means SI value. I need to calculate vector value. I need to calculate the CGS value. That is CGS value of the work. Right? From this what you got? We know the general formula how to convert. How to convert? N2 equal to N1 into bracket. M1 divided by M2 raised to A. L1 divided by L2 raised to B. E1 divided by E2 raised to C. General formula how to convert? We know A value, B value, C value. Right? 1 kg here. 1 kg mean how much gram again? 1000 gram. 1000 can be written 10 to 3. 1 meter mean how many centimeter? How much centimeter? 100 centimeter. 100 centimeter can be written like this. Right? Now I will do like this. M1 already is there, 10, right? M1, what is M1? M1 equal to 1 kg, 1 kg mean how much gram? 10 to 3 gram, M2 mean how much gram? That is 1 gram only, raised to A. A, A value how much? That is 1. 1 value. Take care of L1, L1 mean 1 meter, 1 meter mean how many centimeter? 10 to 3 centimeter, 1 centimeter. Raised to B. B mean how much? This is 2. 2 value. Right or wrong? T1. T1 equal to 1 second and T2 also 1 second. Raised to minus 2. Right? Right or wrong? Gram, gram cancel, centimeter, centimeter cancel, second, second cancel. Will I put again? N2 equal to 10. 10 dash to 3 by 1, raised to 1. 10 dash to 3 by 1, 10 dash to 1. Raised to 1 is there. That becomes 10 dash to 3. 10 dash to 2 by 1, 10 dash to 2. Yes, square is there. 10 dash to 2 into 2. 10 dash to 4. Are you getting this point? 1 by 1, that is 1. 1 dash to minus 2, that is 1. What about 10 dash to 4, 10 dash to 3, 10 dash to 7,
10 to the 7 into 1. How much 10 to the 8? 10 to the 8. And what I got from this? 10 joule. 10 joule equal to 10 to the 8 arch. 10 to the 8 arch. Are you following this? How to convert one system of units into another system of units? Students, some homework I will do. Just convert and just practice it. I will take one homework as convert 1 newton into time. 1 newton into time. Convert 1 joule into arch. Just make the practice. Second application and third application we will see in the next video. Thank you.